y'all. My name is Jasmine, aka Trini, and welcome to Trini TV. Today I want to talk to y'all about hair because I feel like I'm at a place now where I can talk about it. So pretty much I just want to share some tips with y'all about like my hair journey, what I use, what I do to my hair, and how I got my hair to go from nay to yay. So first thing first, I want to make it known that this is not a video that's going to give you, where I'm going to provide you answers on how to make your hair grow. I'm not an expert in that area, so I can't really say too much. So yeah, this video is just mainly going to be about like me giving y'all tips about, you know, just my hair journey and how to retain length to your hair. Because what a lot of people fail to realize is they be looking for all these answers on YouTube and Google and stuff like that, trying to figure out how they can make their hair grow, when in all actuality the hair growth isn't the issue. The issue most of the time be just retaining hair length. And that was something that I didn't realize until I got older, or later on down my hair journey line, where I realized like, oh snap, my hair grows, I just needed to actually not break off and stay long. So here's tip number one, is going to be moisturizing your hair. This is so key. This is crucial in retaining hair length, because a lot of people suffer from hair breakage and split ends because simply their hair is just dry. It's just as simple as that. Your hair is dry, boo. You need to moisturize it. For me, moisturizing my hair, I use hair cream and I use hair oil. Those are my best friends. They go hand in hand. And that's it. It's just as simple as that. That's what I use. I used to use African hair oil. And I'm going to just insert a picture so y'all know exactly what I'm talking about. And I'll get this from the Family Dollar. All my hair stuff, most of the time, I just get it from Family Dollar. Because for one, I'm very frugal with my money. And for two, I'm not paying for high label hair products to do something to my hair that something from Dollar General or Family Dollar can do, you know. I've always been like that. For moisturizing, I used to use Olive Miracle shea butter, Olive Miracle, and olive oil, Olive Miracle, I think that's what it's called. I use those two all the time. And now I make my own hair oil because I have, my scalp gets dry and itchy, so I use a combination of coconut oil, jojoba oil, and tea tree oil. I use that and it does miracles for my scalp. I love it. I use that and I put a little bit on the rest of my hair, like my hair shaft. And then for my hair cream, I use OSR hair moisturizing lotion. I'm gonna just post a picture for y'all to see. I use that now, but right now it's lost. I don't know where it's at because my boyfriend is using my hair stuff too. Here's my hair oil. It's running low now. I gotta re-up. I gotta make some more soon. And then I think I got this from the Family Dollar as well. And I've been using this because I bought it just because I was out and I was staying out somewhere and I just need to grab something, and this was all I seen. But this is pretty good too, but it's not as thick, but it's still good enough. It's good enough for me. So I use that, and you see, it's like that. It, to me, it's not that thick. I like it to be a little bit more thick, but I guess because this is a leave-in conditioner and the other one is a hair lotion, that's why it's like different consistency. So I'm gonna just say that I prefer using hair lotions, I guess. But when I do use this, I use shea butter I use shea butter to lock in the moisture in my hair. But when I use the other one that I just showed y'all a picture of, I use castor oil to seal in my ends. But it really don't make a difference. But I don't know, preference, I guess. So yeah, moisturizing your hair is very
crucial. When it comes to moisturizing your hair, you can either do the LiQ method or you can do the LCO method. They're pretty much the same thing, but just vice versa.
So the LiQ method is liquid oil and cream, and then the LCO method is liquid cream and oil. I'm not sure what the difference is, like what it does to your hair, like how switching those two around does anything differently for your hair, but it's, I guess you could say it's a preference, or it just depends on like whatever the results are is why I guess people do either or. But for me, I've always done the LiQ method because that was the first method I ever heard of, and ever since then I've always done that and I never looked back once. LiQWYD is the water. You moisturize your hair with the water, and then the oil seals in the moisture from the water into your hair, and then the cream seals in the oil to your hair and moisturize your hair and makes your hair shiny and soft and yada yada boom. Depending on what type of moisturizer you use, some of them are like good for just like repairing your hair if you have like breakage, or just preventing breakage to your hair, whatever. So yeah, whatever type of moisturizer you decide to use is up to you, because it should all just depend on what your hair needs. And the same thing with your hair oil. Whatever hair oil you use should just depend on what your hair needs, how dry your hair is, or if your hair breaks off easily, so you want to use something that's like anti-hair breakage, like that all depends on you. But the main thing is just to make sure that your hair stays moisturized by using an oil and a cream and some type of water-based hair product or just water. So moisturize your hair and then LiQ in the moisture into your hair. Alongside moisturizing your hair, you do want to deep condition your hair at least once a month. Some people do other things like protein treatments. I used to do protein treatments too because my hair is pretty fragile and I really wanted to just make sure that my hair strands stay strong so they are not more prone to breakage as easy. So I do protein treatments every like maybe other month whenever I remember to. But for the most part, I do a deep condition treatment once a month. And some people do hot oil treatments as well. I can't say if that's used as a replacement for a deep conditioner or not, but I just know people do that. And they do hair masks as well. So, but you definitely want to do some type of deep moisturizing treatment to your hair at least once a month. Put it like that. Okay, so moisturizing your hair is number one. That's key. The second thing that you want to do after you moisturize your hair, you want to protect your hair. So how do you protect your hair? By doing protective hairstyles. Okay, so for me, I like to do box braids. I like to do crochet. I used to wear fake ponytails and stuff like that too. This type of hairstyle that's going to keep you from having to do your hair every day and tuck the ends of your hair in, and just like keeping it safe from like the outside weather, especially like in the winter weather can be pretty harsh and the air is more dry and stuff like that, and that affects your hair, that dries your hair out and stuff. Sewing or whatever, anything where your hair is just like braided up or twisted up or whatever like that, or just pulled back but not too tight because you don't want your edges to start breaking and your hair start pulling out and stuff. So I normally like do box braids. Box braids is like my go-to. I do my own box braids and my braids don't be tight. I don't braid too tight when I'm doing it on my own head, and that's not by choice. It's just literally, that's just for some reason I can't braid tight on my own head, but if I do it to somebody else's head, it's really tight. So yeah, I braid my own hair. I do my own box braids. When I don't have weave in my hair, I normally just wear my hair in like a bun, because I'm in the military too, so like I be having to wear it in a bun. So that's just like my main go-to hairstyle. Yeah, so that's really pretty much it. Those are like the key factors to retaining hair length, is keeping your hair moisturized and wearing protective hairstyles. Some additional tips that I want to give to you guys is, for one, don't overdo it with hair products. People are gonna try to sell you hair products all the time that say, oh, this is gonna make your hair grow, this is key to hair growth or whatever, da da da, all you gotta do is pay $20. And you go out and you buy those hair products and it don't be no different than the hair products that they're selling at the dollar store. If you want like stuff that defines your curls and stuff like that, then yeah, that is a whole different ball game. There are hair products for that stuff. I use curl definers sometimes too. Eco Style Gel is like really good. There's this other one too. I just threw it away because I just finished it. But yeah, those are good too. You can use those, but just be careful because you don't want to overdo it because it will build up and you do have to wash that stuff out your hair eventually. But with the hair products, when I say don't overdo it, so like, someone told us at the hair store that they use castor oil to make their hair grow. And so my boyfriend started using it, but it seemed like he wanted me to put it in his hair every day. And I'm like, babe, like, you can't put this in your hair every day because it's still a thick oil and it will clog your hair pores and then your hair won't grow. Don't be that person. Don't be the person overdoing it with their hair products because you're trying to get your hair to grow. Because like I said, most of the time it's not your hair growth that's the issue, it's just the retention of it. You just need enough to moisturize your hair until your next wash day. Now, some people may have to moisturize their hair more than others, but that can also just depend on what type of hair product that you are using as well. So the next thing I want to say is avoid tight hairstyles, because like I said, when you're doing protective hairstyles, you don't want nothing that's going to be too tight and abrasive that's going to cause your hair to break, pulling on your ends, pulling on your hair and stuff like that. You don't want that. Minimize heat usage. So all those heat tools that you use, you might want to minimize that if you are that type of person. I personally just like to press out my hair once a year just for a lymph check and to get my ends trimmed. When it comes to dry your hair with a t-shirt instead of a towel, because towels apparently causes breakage to your hair because of the material of it. So I was always told to just use a t-shirt instead, so that's what I do. Also, when you're drying your hair, you can either air dry your hair or you can use your blow dryer if you want to, but just use it on a cool setting. You want to also avoid using shampoos that have parabens and sulfates because those ingredients dry out your hair. So what I say is when you're using a shampoo, look for a shampoo that says it's like free from sulfates or parabens, or that's like made with all natural organic ingredients, because you don't want to be using anything in your hair that's going to dry and strip your hair of its natural oils. For me personally, I used to use cold washes, but even with using the cold wash, every so often you still have to shampoo your hair because a cold wash only washes your hair but so much. It's not a deep cleanser. So if you want to use a deep cleanser when you're washing your hair, I personally use apple cider vinegar. And it does my hair justice. And it's great because it's amazing for your scalp and it makes your hair shiny. And that's what I'm gonna say. Because I struggle with dry scalp. So yeah, it's really good for your scalp. It really digs deep and gets all that buildup and stuff out of your hair. And scalp massages. Scalp massages is good for blood circulation in your head, and it is actually good for hair growth. So that's one hair growth tip I got, is massaging your scalp. Other than that, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope it was useful and you really gained something from it, because I've gained a lot from watching hair videos. So I'm just trying to share some knowledge, drop some gems for y'all, and just mainly let y'all know that you don't have to do the most when it comes to getting your hair to retain. Like, you don't really have to do the most. And when it comes to hair products, you don't have to have 50 million hair products up in your bathroom. I really try to keep my hair products down to a minimum because I don't like to have unnecessary stuff, and that's just unnecessary money coming out of my pocket. And pretty much that is it. That's a wrap for my hair video. So I hope y'all enjoy, and peace to the Middle East.